What's up, Order Nation? It's your boy Lowe's, and in front of me, I got the lovely Rajayla Buckner. She's here from the Rose City, and we're going to be talking about some shit today. Thank you for coming on, Rajayla.
Thanks for inviting me.
You look nice in the red. You know, it's
Thank
the offset
you.
Of that chocolate. You know how that goes. You just went to the dentist.
I did. I just got my teeth pulled because it was hurting. Had like a little infection. I don't even know how I got it because I don't eat sweets.
An abscess?
It was like an infection inside the gum. It was like, yeah, it was bad. And I was like, I don't eat sweets, so how did I get this? And he was just like, I'm just
Maybe it's because you're chocolate. You know, you're so sweet from the inside.
I didn't think about it like that.
Yeah, that sucks. I've had cavities. I got teeth missing. And, yeah, it sucks. Was it your first time getting a teeth pulled?
Second. But it hurt worse. The first time, it wasn't that bad. It was just like, I don't know. Maybe it's because I was heavier, so I had like a little extra meat back there.
Well, speaking of which, you've kind of gone through this whole health transformation of sorts.
I did.
In high school, you were in shape.
Was.
Then you hit a bit of depression because your grandmother passed away?
Yes.
So you gained, how much weight did you gain?
I graduated high school, I was about like 145. And so I gained about 40 pounds, 45, because I went to 185. Yeah.
Did it affect your health in any way, your sleep?
No, but my knees would hurt and my back would hurt. So I would say it affected my health, but like I would just take like painkillers.
So you would, on top of numbing your physical pain, you would numb the emotional pain?
Yeah.
How close were you to your grandmother?
My bestie.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. Was she kind of like the person that raised you?
No, I was raised by my mom, but we just was like, we stayed like right there.
Mm-hmm.
So I seen her like almost every day, or like out of a 7-day week, probably like a good 5 or 6 days. And if I didn't see her one day, I always talked to her.
Okay. And you feel that your connection, or anyone's connection to their grandmother, is very important?
Yes, definitely. Like, it's like a greenie. It's like the key that holds you, you know, just holds you up.
Okay.
It's mine's dead.
Right. And you know, both of my grandmas have passed. One grandma passed away this year, so I exactly know what you mean. And I wasn't able to be there, so.
Really?
Yeah, I kind of know what it's like, you know what I mean? But she was in Mexico, so it's a little
Yeah, and then with the pandemic and stuff.
Right. Where'd you go to high school?
John Tyler.
Okay, Cujo.
Yeah, Lions.
What year did you graduate?
2015.
Okay, so not too long ago.
Yeah.
I mean, in a sense, because I graduated way before.
Yeah, about years ago. Just not that long ago.
When did you know that you wanted to run track?
Well, I kind of just got through in there. Mom just kind of like threw me in there when I was younger. I needed some sports. She wanted me to stay active and fit. And I really wasn't a girly girl. I tried out gymnastics. That really wasn't for me. So I did summer track. That was the first thing I did. I did summer track. And I really liked it. And I just kept going. Then I played like other sports. But like track is what kept me grounded and sane. Because like in basketball, you know, it's only so much you can do. So I would always get fouled out of the game because they would say I was too aggressive. And then softball really wasn't for me because it says softball, but the balls are really hard, and after getting hit so many times, I'm like, yeah, no, this ain't for me. So the only thing I liked was track, and like when I would get in trouble with mama, I know I could just go run and just, you know, scream. Or if I was like stressed, I'd just like run. That's when I like to run miles because I know I can just keep running and everything will go away. Not literally, but you know, it'll go away from any time.
Okay. When did you start seeing that you were good at it, like in terms of success?
When I kept placing over and over, and when different track clubs wanted me, like the track club that I started out with was East Texas Track Club, but they only had outdoor, they didn't have indoor. So this other indoor team wanted me, but I like to kind of stay with who I know, who kind of like, cause I don't like doing different programs, like do this thing here and then go back and do this thing there. So like they was like, you were good, you can help out relay out an indoor. And I was like, yeah, probably could, but it's not really something I want to do because like, I don't really know y'all like that. And I'm only gonna be with y'all short term. And I was like, well, all these clubs kind of want me, so maybe I am the GOAT. And then I realized, you know, not to be cocky, but middle school, they couldn't make it without me. I was like, you know, fourth leg. I ended, I started. Pretty much like that.
What type are you a sprinter?
Yeah, a sprinter. I just got thrown to 800 this year. Not something I like, but I run it because, you know, if you can run an 800, you can run anything. Really, if you can run a 400, you can run anything. It's Rajayla, and when you're done watching this video, be sure to subscribe to Odo Nation.